Okay, so today we are going to see the other part of potential and potential energy. The other part is apart from derivation, the other part is how to find the how to do the numericals based on potential and potential energy. We are first going to start with the numericals based on potential. Now, if you see here, what does it say? It says the definition of potential, which says potential is equal to work done by charge, that is work done per unit charge. Which work done? Work done means, let us say if I move the charge from A to B, divided the charge, this charge is that charge which we move. Remember this. This is the charge, the movable charge, the moving charge. So if I move a charge from A to B in a potential difference of B and A, there is a way we write B A here. That means that will be clear to over that will this will be clear over there. So this is the potential difference across those two points A and B, and this is the work done from A to B divided by charge Q naught. So if I cross multiply this Q naught over here, I will get Q naught into VBA. So what is this? This is work done from A to B, which is equal to the charge which you are moving multiplied by the potential difference BA. Now why we write BA? Because B is the final position. It is coming to B from A. So B is final, A is initial. So final minus initial. So if I keep it very simple, this is the work done formula. It says charge V final minus V initial. Based on this, we are going to discuss some question. But let us try to first find how to find potential. Now for a point charge, so the whole objective is let us first learn how to find potential, and then we are going to apply this in this formula, and then we will find the work done. So if you have to learn how to find potential, then you have to first recall what is the potential due to a point charge. Point charge, as per the derivation in the last lecture, it is given as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r, where r is the point where I want to find the potential. So r is the distance between the charge and the point where you want to find the potential. Now it will be more clear to you over here. Suppose I have combination of two charges, and I want to find potential at this particular point. And that point is the midpoint between these two charges. So distance is r by 2, r by 2. Now don't mix this with the electric field concept. Electric field is a vector quantity, whereas what we are doing here with scalar quantity. Potential is scalar quantity. When we say potential, unit is volt. Correct? Remember class 10 electricity. Potential as a unit of volt. Volt is basically a scalar quantity. It can have a negative potential, it may have a positive potential, but it does not have any direction. So we will just simply add up the two potentials at this particular point called O. How? Like this. So potential at point O will be because of Q1 and because of Q2. Now what is because of Q1? Because of Q1, it will be Q1, distance between the charge and the point of observation is R by 2, plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q2, distance between the charge and the point of observation, that is R by 2. This is as simple as that, simple addition. When to subtract? You have to subtract when the potential itself is negative. And who creates negative potential? Negative potential is created by negative charge. And that is my next question over here. For example, let us say example 3. In example 3, you have this charge as minus Q1 and this charge is minus Q2. And this distance is r, and this is the point O, and this distance is r by 2 and r by 2, and I want to find what is the potential at point O. Potential at point O will be is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 at a distance of r by 2. Remember, it's negative, so you will write minus Q1. Here you have to take the sign of charge, minus Q1 divided by r by 2 plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Q2 is positive, so I will write as positive and r by 2. This is example 2, example 3. This is example 1 for point charge, example 2, and this is example 3. Let's go for example 4. Example 4 is this one. Suppose if you have a system in which, an equilateral system in which you have placed three charges. I am intentionally using one negative charge so that you will learn it how to find. And this is your Q1 and this is your Q2. And let us say this is the point where the centroid meets. So this distance is r, this distance is r. I'm calling it as r, and this is also r. And now this is the point O where I want to find the potential. So any guess? Potential at that particular point will be equal to potential at this point will be because of q1, because of q2, and because of q3. So I will take 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught formula. You can always do that because it's no matter writing 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught every time. So just take it common, and then this is q1 by r plus q2 by r plus minus q3 by r. Done. So positive potential, negative charge, negative potential. As simple as that. Let us do one more example over here. Example 5. Suppose if you have a square shaped structure here, A and A. Okay, I have taken in the sheet as R, R, R and R. And there are three charges at the three corners. Say that this is Q3, this is Q1, and this one is minus Q2. And I want to find at the fourth corner what is my potential. There is no charge at the fourth corner. It's empty. So I want to find what is the potential at point O. So potential at point O will be because of Q3. Now Q3 is maintaining a distance of R. Q2 is maintaining a distance of R. What about Q1? Q1 is maintaining a distance of diagonal, and diagonal is root 2R. How to get diagonal length? That is Pythagoras theorem, root over of perpendicular square plus root over, that is in a hypotenuse, if this is your A and this is your B, then this becomes A square plus B square. And if both are A, then it both becomes A square, and that is equal to root 2 times of A. I am sure many of you know this. So I will take 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught common. So Q3 by R plus minus Q2 by R plus Q1 by root 2R. And that is your answer for this. Okay? There's nothing over here. And that's how we find the potential at the fourth corner where there is no charge. So now we have more or less some idea on how to find the potential at a point. So the same logic, the basic logic is this. See the point where you have to find the field, where you have to find the potential. See the distance between the charge and that particular point. Use the formula 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r. If q is positive, keep q positive. If q is negative, keep q negative. So it's as simple as that. No direction here. No direction at all. Positive charge will create positive potential. Negative charge will create negative potential. Now let's go ahead and let's do some more numericals based on work done now. So as I told you, work done is q naught, v final, where I am moving and from where I am moving. How to do this question now? For example, suppose I have a quadrant over here and this is the circular arc over here. I have to move a charge of Q0 from here to here, and there is a charge here Q plus Q sitting at this point. And this distance is R, since it is a circular arc, this radius is also R. And this Q0 is the charge which I am moving. So I am moving this charge from this point, from point A, and I am moving this point to point B. Now in the question, they may say I have moved over a circular arc. Doesn't matter even if you move any other path. So long you are coming from A to B, it does not matter from which path you come. Remember in conservative field like electric field is a conservative field, and the formula for potential which says 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r, it only defines where, it does not define how you have reached there. It only says here to here. How you are going there, like this, or through no doubt, doesn't matter. It just depends on one point to another point. So we will apply over here this concept over here. So this charge is moving, forget this charge. This charge is coming here. Who is going to create the potential? The potential will be created by the charge other than the moving charge. Who is there other than the moving charge? Only this charge is present other than the moving charge. So potential will be equal to work done will be equals to q naught, the charge which you are moving, v final, this is the final point, distance is r. So 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r. initial point. Initial point is this. There is a minus sign in the formula. So minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r. So this is my v final and this is my v initial. The good thing is v final and v initial is same. That means potential at point A and potential at point B is same. So these two cancels out and hence the work done is zero. The good thing about IAC is many times when they ask question based on potential, work done using potential, many a times the answer is zero. IAC generally don't complicate the questions and they keep it very simple. I have taken one example purposefully over here so that you will get an idea that when the work done is not zero. So other, I am going to discuss another example over here. Another example is this. So suppose if you have a Cartesian coordinate system like this and there is one charge which is kept over here and this charge is having a value of q and the coordinate of this point is minus a comma 0. There is another charge over here which is also q and the coordinate point is a comma 0. And this is one point where the charge q naught is placed and the coordinate is 0 comma a. And I have to move this charge through some path and I have to make sure that it reaches over here. This is the final point. So if I consider this point as point A and this point is point B, then this point I have to place the charge and the coordinate of this point is 0 comma minus a. So this is my initial and this is my final. Answer is 0. Let's see how. If this is initial, q naught is the moving charge. Who is going to create the potential here? This q and this q. Distance is this one. Now if this is a and if this is a, what is this distance? This distance is root 2a. If this is a and if this is a, this distance is root 2a. So what is the potential at point A? Potential at point A is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by root 2a plus q by root 2a. Now let's find the potential at point B, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Now when it finally reaches over here, this is the distance, it maintains, q maintains that r value. So what is r? This is a, this is a. So this is again root 2a. This is a, this is a. So this distance is again root 2a. So even this will be also root 2a plus q by root 2a, the length, the distance. And you can see here VA and VB are exactly same. So when I put them in the formula of Q naught, VB minus VA, immediately what will I get? I will get this as 0 because initial potential and final potentials are same. Okay. I have left one example here. Just try to think on this. Use your own common sense. It's a worked out example. I'm not going to discuss here. This example is already worked out over here. Try to see, but remember here the work done is not zero in the third example. Okay, so let's go and let's try to see numerical based on potential energy. IAC once upon a time has asked question like this, that there is an orbit. Electrons are moving in a shell and there is a nucleus of some Z atom. So total number of proton charge at the nucleus will be Z into mass of proton at the nucleus. So this is my nucleus and they are asking me what is the potential and radius of R. So at radius of R, there is no electron. There is no electron in the orbit. So just they have to find the potential at this particular point. So potential formula is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R. And what is Q here? Q is the charge of the nucleus and nucleus is the charge of Z times of E, where Z is the total number, the atomic number, and atomic number means total number of protons, and proton also has the same charge. You know this from your childhood knowledge that proton also has the same charge as that of electron but positive. So it is going to create a positive potential and radius of R. So even this IAC has asked question based on. Okay, moving ahead. Numerical based on potential energy. Now potential energy numerical intentionally I am doing after potential is because I believe that potential energy numericals are easier for you. Why it is easier? Try to recall gravitational chapter. We have done questions based on this. Well, you have three buses and I ask you what is the mass, what is the potential energy of each of the system. and there we saw gm1 m2 by r, gm1 m1 m3 by r, and gm2 m3 by r, you know, number of pair. So it goes in the same way here also. So potential energy formula, remember potential energy is always between two charges. You need to have two charges to create this formula. If both are positive, this product remains positive. If both are negative, the product becomes negative. Sorry, if both are positive, product is positive. If both are negative, product is positive. If one is positive, one is negative, product is negative. So how do they ask questions based on potential energy? So suppose they may ask you, what is the potential energy of this system? Now this system means, let us say I have Q1 and then I have Q2 and then I have Q3. How will you find the potential energy of the system if the side length is R? This is R, this is R, this is R. Now Q1, Q2 is one pair, Q1, Q3 is another pair, and Q2, Q3 is the last pair. So I will write the formula like this, take 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught common, Q1, Q3, Q1, Q3 by R plus Q1 minus Q2. So Q1 minus Q2 by R plus Q3 minus Q2 by R, and done. Use your calculator, solve this, and you get the answer right away. This is how we find potential energy of a system. Now, a system may also contain a system can also have a shape like square. This is also possible. Q1, Q2, Q1, Q2, Q3, and Q4. So if I consider this distance as A, 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 and A, then what is this length? This length will be equal to root 2 times of A, root 2 times of A. How many pairs are there? Q1, Q2 is one pair, Q2, Q4 is one pair, Q4, Q3 is one pair, Q3, Q1 is one pair, Q1, Q4 is the fifth pair, and Q2, Q3 is the last pair. So here also, if you have to find the potential energy, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, Q1, Q2 divided by Q1, Q2 by A, plus Q2, Q3 by A, plus Q3, Q4 by A, plus Q4, Q1 by A, plus Q1, Q3 by root 2A, plus Q2, Q4 by root 2A. And this becomes the potential energy of the system. Don't get panicked, like you may think there are 6 terms, but just imagine if Q1, Q2, Q3 and Q4 all are same thing. It becomes slightly smaller. You have to just take something common and you will get the answer easily. Even if you can't do, then do it, because you have calculator to use. So just keep multiplying your calculator and definitely you will get the answer. But I want to do one question which I will teach you how to do this question. Because why I am saying this? Because there is an area of silly mistake based on this. So I will teach a different type of question now based on same logic, but with numbers, so that you will understand where you do the silly mistake. So this is the question I want to select now. This is important one also. Example 3, under the heading of potential energy. So suppose if you have a system like this, where you have this as 2 microcoulomb, minus 3 microcoulomb and 4 microcoulomb, separated by a distance of 2 cm, 2 cm, 2 cm. Before we go to the question, let's find the potential here. What is the potential here? Take 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught common. Q1, Q2. So you will write 2 into 10 power minus 6. Microcoulomb is 10 power minus 6. Multiplied by 4 into 10 power minus 6. What people do, they will multiply 2 and 4 and then they will put only 1 micro value. That means 2 into 4, 8 into 10 power minus 6. Other 10 power minus 6 is gone somewhere. We don't know where. Divided by distance. If distance is in centimeter, you are supposed to write that also in terms of meter. 10 power minus 2, centimeter to meter. Plus this and this. Now 4 into 10 power minus 6 into minus 3 into 10 power minus 6. Divided by 2 into 10 power minus 2 plus last pair is 3 and 2. So minus 3 into 10 power minus 6 into 2 into 10 power minus 6 divided by 2 into 10 power minus 2. This is the potential energy of the system with numbers. So area of silly mistake, you forget to put power everywhere and you forget to convert centimeter into meter. Now which question, what I am going to try to do is, this is the potential energy of this system. But what if I have to do some work on this system? I did some work on this system and then I transform the entire configuration to a different configuration such that I have doubled the side length. So if I double the side length, my distance becomes 4 centimeter now. And this is 2 microcoulomb and this is 4 microcoulomb and then this one will be your minus 3 microcoulomb. Then the question they ask is, what is the work done in changing the configuration from this system to that system? Okay? How are you going to find this? So from this system to that system means you first find what is the potential energy of this system. You mark this as U initial. Then you find what is the potential energy of this system. You mark that as U final. In U final, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, what's the difference? The numerator remains same. So this becomes 2 into 10 power minus 6 into 4 into 10 power minus 6 divided by 4 into 10 power minus 2 plus 4 into 10 power minus 6 into minus 3 into 10 power minus 6 divided by 4 into 10 power minus 2 plus minus 3 into 10 power minus 6 into 2 into 10 power minus 6 divided by 2 into 10 power minus 4, sorry, 4 into 10 power minus 2. This is my U final. How will you find the work done? Work done can be now find by simply using this logic of U final minus U initial. U final minus U initial. Okay? That's it. Sometimes they will ask this question also. Other than this, if anything is asked, it is more easy. So if they ask you that this is the configuration over here, I want to deassemble this entire system such that all the charges went to infinity. All the charges has gone to infinity. If I have to deassemble this system, and final separation must be, each charge must be separated by infinite distance. What do you think this value will be in the denominator? Infinity, infinity, infinity. Something by infinity, 0, 0, 0. What is U final? 0. Okay? Or the other way around. All the charges are there at infinite separation. I brought them and I created this system. So in that case, U initial will become 0 and U final will have this kind of value with whatever distance they are asking you. So in U initial, if I am bringing from infinity and I suppose from infinity I brought to them in this configuration, forget that. So from infinity, I am bringing from infinity. So initial is infinity, 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 0, 0, 0, U initial is 0 and then comes and makes this system. So U final is this. How to find work done? U final minus U initial. So if something you are sending to infinity, final potential will be 0. If you are bringing from infinity, initial potential will be 0. And whatever system is created, IC can at the most can go from triangular shape to a square shape. Square shape also we have learned how to find potential energy of a square shape system. Okay. So what is your prep? The prep here is you have to do the question based from the book chapter wise question bank which is there. Open the chapter of potential and potential energy and do the numericals. Because the more you do the numericals on daily basis, the more good you will become in physics. Okay, so thank you. And next will be another very interesting topic on potential energy. In the next class, we are going to relate how potential is related to electric field. Very beautiful equation. Thank you.